game of cricket with one of the all-time great players in the sport, Sir Gary Silvers. And while we're introducing you to the game of cricket, we're going to take some time and introduce the locals, the Barbadians, to the finer points of the game of basketball with former NBA star Maurice Lucas and current LA Clipper Harold Ellis. Also joining me here on the island of Barbados is our own Angela Stribling. And Angela, we talked about what we're going to be doing with sports. What are you going to be doing with us while we're here?
Well, as you know, right now Barbados is having crop over. So it's an excellent time to get involved with sports as well as entertainment. But for starters, I'm going to do one of my favorite things, is shop.
Don't spend too much money now.
Well, I'll try not to, mainly because Barbados is also known for their nightlife. So in fact, will you join me at some of the clubs tonight?
Hey, I don't know if I can hang with you.
Come on, Charlie, you can hang.
All right, it should be a whale of a time. Stay with us. More from Barbados in just a moment. New sense of pride that Barbados enters its third decade of independence. Despite the island's dense population, 260,000 people live in a space divided into 11 parishes and 4 regions. Just 14 miles wide and 21 miles long, Barbadians have one of the highest per capita incomes in the Caribbean and boast a proud tradition of a stable, democratic government. Barbados is the ideal place to relax and enjoy yourself. Soak in the sun and sea, explore the beach, and savor some of the best food and rum punch in the Caribbean. Witness one of the most competitive sports in the world, cricket. For tourists, you couldn't find a Caribbean island with any more conveniences of home. While cricket is a sport of choice by most Bajans, cable TV has brought the attraction of the NBA to the forefront of most young people. We thought it would be a good idea to bring a few people along on our trip who knew something about basketball. Former NBA star Maurice Lucas and present Hooper Harold Ellis of the Los Angeles Clippers.
My name is Harold Ellis. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia, and I graduated from Morehouse College in Atlanta. I didn't play in high school. I got cut from the team in high school, and I played my senior year in high school. And then I didn't have too many athletic scholarships going to college, so I chose to go to Morehouse College, which is a predominantly black school. While at Morehouse, I was playing basketball. While still in school, and I had a shot to play in the NBA. And Morehouse is considered a very small school as far as basketball, trying to make it to the pros. But I was the first person ever to make it from Morehouse to the NBA. The layup and rebound line, you know, basically layup. And then we're going to warm up like that. Yeah, we're going to warm up like that. Yeah. Hey, y'all basically do this all the time, right? Y'all do this all the time, right? Okay. I just wanted to make sure. Because we're just getting warmed up. Then we're going to get into some one-on-one. All right, I'm going to show y'all the drill right quick. It's called knockout. Well, my team, we played it a lot, and it helps develop one-on-one skills. All right, Ryan will first try to score on me, and I'm coming up, and I got to play defense on Ryan to try to stop him from scoring. Now, if he scores, I'm knocked out. Then I have to go sit on the side. All right, I always enjoy it, especially when...
Two unwanted teams. They're brought into this camp as a starter. We go to basic fundamentals at this camp. Then they're put into the domestic competition where they play against much bigger, older guys. Some of these kids are ready for college. Because let's say David Burnett, for instance, who's at Morehouse right now. He's a graduate of this camp and the combined schools team. The problem is the opportunities. We don't have coaches or people like you come down here that often. You know, Barbados is so easterly, the most easterly of the Caribbean islands, so we don't have coaches come this far down.
For your stomach. Skill and strategy. No matter what faith one might observe, Bajans can all agree on one religion, cricket. For most Bajans, cricket is just that serious. It's not unusual for a match to take as long as 5 days to complete and can still result in a tie. Hi, I'm Charlie Neal, and
We're here on the beautiful island of Barbados, and one of the things that the island is famous for in terms of sports is the game of cricket. And we're going to spend some time with some people who not only know the game of cricket, but know the game of basketball. We have some cricket players here, we have some basketball players here, and they're going to ask some questions of each other. First of all, one of the most famous cricket players of all times, and I'm not just talking about from the island of Barbados, I'm talking about worldwide. Sir Gary Sobers is here with us. Another young man who's a cricket player here on the island and playing for the island of Barbados is Ryan O'Neill. I'd like to say hello to these gentlemen. Also behind me to my left is a guy who played professional basketball in the NBA with the Portland Trail Blazers, Maurice Lucas. He's holding a bat in his hand, doesn't know what to do with it other than try to hit somebody upside the head. And over here from the Los Angeles Clippers is Harold Ellis.
First of all, the game is played with two teams of 11 players each. And the toss, you spin a coin to see who's going to bat or who's going to field. At times, when the captain wins the toss, he doesn't necessarily have to bat. Mm-hmm. Because he can look at the wicket, and if he thinks that the wicket has got a little bit of moisture in it, he can ask the other team to bat.
Mm-hmm. Now, what's the wicket?
The wicket is, the pitch. The playing area we play it on. The wickets are the two stumps you put it.
How far apart?
22 left. Yards.
22 yards.
22 yards.
See, I knew you thought a wicket was something else.
Right. Right. But the bowler's limit, the bowler's run-up is not limited.
That's
only
the ball.
Yes.
That's the ball mm-hmm. that they use.
And this
to pitch
is the
with.
Bat.
This is the bat.
All right.
And they have to hit this with this.
When you have real fast bowlers, for instance, bowlers that bowl at the speed of 90 miles an hour, mm-hmm. and the ball sometimes when it hit the pitch can bounce awkward.
Right.
And if it's not bouncing even, you're liable to get hit on the fingers.
Mm-hmm.
So you need these gloves to protect your fingers.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why we have the gloves,
mm-hmm.
similar to the pads. Mm-hmm. Now, the pads are something that you use. You use them all the time because it's supposed to be the second line of defense. You put the bat to the ball, but if the ball misses the bat, then it's going to hit your legs.
Right.
So you have the pads on your legs to protect your legs.
Mm-hmm.
Because again, if you get a bowler that's bowling at a 90-odd miles and it hits you on mm-hmm. your foot without pads on, well, you know what kind of damage it could do.
Sure.
So that's why we use pads, and you find that inside the pads are reinforced,
mm-hmm.
so that it takes most of the blows.
Now, you also, I noticed you have the soft hat on, Ryan. Why the soft hat? Everybody wears a hat, basically, especially the batters.
Just due to the sun. The sun is
keep the sun out.
The sun is your eyes.
Uh-huh.
Use a helmet if the bowler's a bit quicker.
Oh, so just in case.
More protection. Extra protection.
Yeah, that's
yes,
good.
And sometimes the hat is used because people are accustomed to use mm-hmm. hats. And,
Harold, you have any questions about?
Yeah, I want to ask a question about the uniform. How do you distinguish the two teams apart? I mean, everybody wears white.
Wears white.
Okay, I mean, is that the national? I mean,
it doesn't matter, I guess. Apparently,
yeah,
it doesn't.
Yeah, you know the teams. There's a batting team and a fielding team.
Okay.
The fielding team's one. You see, in the field, 11 players out there in the fielding team. The batter, the batting team, only two guys out there.
Okay.
And two guys wearing the batting.
Okay. Well, how did you choose the color white? That's what I'm saying. How is it?
That's
been
cool.
History?
But maybe
why did they pick that color?
I think one of the reasons for the white is because you have a red ball, and therefore the red ball stands out against the white background. And the colors is something that is, they've been there from as far back as we can remember, from the time the game started. And since then, the colors have changed, because you do have the one-day cricket, where it was started in Australia, where the West Indies would wear a maroon, England used to wear blue, Australia wore a yellow, and so on and so on. But that was good. I thought it was good from the point of view as what you've just said. How do you know? Well, you see, you would know from that if you see one team in blue, you would know that that is an England team. If you see one in green, you would know that that's India. And if you saw one in yellow, you would know that's Australia, mm-hmm. and so on and so on. So you can make some kind of distinction between them. Now, also in the one-day games, they carry their names on the back of the mm-hmm. of the back of their shirts. Again, you would know, well, that is Vivian Richards, who was mm-hmm. one of our great players, or Richie Richardson, or Ian Chappell, or whoever. And I think that is good from that point of view. But a lot of people still do not believe in the color scheme. They still like the old whites that they started with from the time, as far back as the game started.
Let's watch Mike Beckles. Plays down on the leg side, gets another single. The whole ploy in limited overs cricket is not to hit the ball as hard necessarily as you can, but to accumulate runs and do it regularly. to keep the over rate moving so that with the last 10 overs, if you have wickets intact, they can be a bit of a slog going after the ball. But once you pick up the singles, pushing the ball here and there and getting the short singles, that's important.
Do women play cricket?
Yes. Years ago, the West Indies used to have a team, and Barbados used to have a team, and they used to play against one another. But they find that there wasn't getting enough support financially, mm-hmm. so they had to give it up.
Traveling to Barbados, bring your credit cards and cash. The exchange rate is about 2-1 compared to Beijing currency. You'll find great buys and most tax-free.
Cropover brings hundreds of people to Barbados. And as you can see, like me, they love to shop. We're on Broad Street where there are literally hundreds of stores to choose from. So come on. Let's go shopping. We're actually in a city that looks like it's any major U.S. downtown area. Come on. This really is a beautiful watch. Charlie!
Yeah.
What are you doing here? I thought you were out playing cricket.
I'm trying to keep you from spending all your money. I heard you were down here in the most expensive part of Barbados trying to buy this watch that cost about $1 million. I heard that.
So, Charlie, I tell you a perfect way to prevent me from spending it.
What's that?
You could buy it for me.
Oh, no, I'm not.
The highlight of the summer is the Cropover Festival, an all-island jubilation from mid-July to early August that celebrates the completion of the sugarcane harvest. There's partying and parading, dancing and eating and good times. The highlight is a night of the crowning of the King and Queen of Calypso. The climax of the festival is Kadumet Day, a national holiday when costumes and bands fill the streets with pulsating Barbadian rhythms. Guess which
accounts for their very competitive nature. We hope the viewing audience has enjoyed what we brought them over the past half hour from this beautiful island of Barbados, which allows a visitor not only a chance to relax, but a chance to be adventurous as well. And I know you really enjoyed yourself.
Oh, absolutely. Speaking of being adventurous, we're here at the perfect time. It's Cropover.
Mm-hmm.
So you get a chance to partake in a lot of different festivities. I even almost walked away with a $14,000 watch. But Charlie would go for it.
No, it's still sitting there, believe me. We have a lot of people we'd like to thank for making this all possible on behalf of BET, especially the Barbados Tourism Board. And on behalf of Angela Stribling and all of us here at BET Sports, Charlie Neal saying so long from Barbados in the West Indies.
Fire, fire, from the stadium. Lord, when I pull me, thought that in their heart. Thought about it. Yeah, I thought that they're riding forward. Fall back to the stop. Look, I wonder what I've got early. Falling by a tear. That's that for rope on fire. And the burning got a gorgeous. Look, I wonder what I've got early. Falling by an engine. That's that for rope on fire.